Special thanks to our sponsors Be Quiet, Lee & Lee, ViewSonic, Fantex, and Deepcool for sending us to CES 2019.
What's going on, everyone? We're going to start this one off with a beautiful view here at Caesar's Tower. If you just look behind me, you can see pretty much the entire Vegas Strip, or at least the north side of it. And this suite is actually being controlled by Lee & Lee right now. They've taken this over, and we're going to show you a lot of their cool new products. They've actually built on some of their more successful older products as well. So it'll be great to see what they're currently working on and what to expect in 2019. Now, I'm sure at this point you guys are familiar with the PCO11 Dynamic, one of my favorite mid-sized towers, if you will. And for the price, I think it's pretty much unbeatable. Now, this is the Razor Edition, and we showed this just briefly at Computex. It wasn't in full-scale production by that point, but this is it. I mean, this is what it's going to look like. This is what you're going to end up buying if you decide to go with the Razor Edition. You can see we've got nice lighting effect on the bottom, both on the left and right side, and we have RGBs on the front panel that kind of, I guess, spread out to the left side, and you can see this Razor logo etched inside the glass. It's actually really cool because if you tried to, you know, feel the etching on this side, you can tell it's not there. It's also not on the other side. It's actually etched inside the glass pane, so that's why it does such a great job capturing the light and gives it just that typical Razor RGB effect. And at the same time, you get a great case like the PCO11 Dynamic. And then another thing, if you pan over here to the Synapse software, it's all controlled inside one software suite, which is something you could do normally with Razer peripherals like keyboards and mice and headsets. But now you also get control of the case RGB, so you can integrate all of it with this software here. It's actually super convenient. You can change the lighting scheme, the effects, how bright the LEDs are. So it's a really nice implementation. And again, one of my favorite cases with something as reliable and beautiful, frankly, as Razer peripherals and lighting. I think it's a great combination. Now, this is an AIO that Lee & Lee is currently working on. You can see it's got the nice Lee & Lee charm. It's got the beautiful accents here on the side. Make it look very premium. You have an AIO. Well, the CPU block itself just looks very nice. Little magnetic cover here. Again, still in the development phase, but I really like the idea. If you want it more ostentatious and just looking flashy, you can do it like that. Or you can just pop that back on. I think it's just a little metal cap, and that keeps it more subdued. So it really kind of fits both style schemes. And then up top, the coolest part about this, in my opinion, is the fact that the pump is integrated into the top of the radiator. So as you've seen in the past, some pumps have been like physically mounted into the rad fins, which could obstruct certain degree of airflow, prevent, you know, certain aspects of the radiator from working properly. But in this case, the pump is removed from both the CPU block and the radiator and is instead placed up top, where you can see the tubes kind of funnel into the rad. So it's a totally new design. I don't think I've seen anything like this before. I really like this idea, and this should allow Lee & Lee to do a lot of cool stuff with the CPU block, because now you don't have the pump in the block. It means you can just, you know, change the shape, how tall it is. All that is now customizable. So hopefully we continue to see this implemented in future designs of Lee & Lee AIOs. Another Lee & Lee staple, these are the Bora light fans, only the difference this time is that they are digital. So typically you'd get three of these in nice aluminum trim around the side. You get the aluminum logo kind of stamped in the middle so that the typically have stickers that are off-center and it looks really weird when the fans spin. Not the case at all here. You can see it's very uniform. And these fans were originally $39.99, right? You could still buy those, just the RGB Bora light fans. But if you want the digital fans, an extra 10 bucks, you get to do cool things like this. I'm just gonna kind of pan through some of them so you can see all the different effects. And we do have a video talking about the difference between non-addressable and addressable RGBs. You can check it out over here if you're interested. But that basically gives us a lot more just versatility. We can control each LED individually with this setup, and you can see the effects themselves are just absolutely beautiful. Now, this is the TU150. Lee & Lee wanted to emphasize both the beauty factor as well as the portability factor. So first off, got this handle here. That's super convenient. You can just kind of tuck it back in if you're interested in taking it anywhere at the moment, and that keeps it looking nice and sleek up top. But again, it's super easy to move if you so desire. And typically, ITX builds are known for their portable aspects. So if you really wanted to build something in a case like this and send it anywhere, carry it, heck, you could carry it like a briefcase. That's one big advantage of the TU150. And then also you can see how they've just made use of pretty much all the space inside this form factor here. So we've got a huge beefy Zotac graphics card in there. We've got a CryoRig H7, looks like, yeah, H7 quad Lumis in there, and just, you know, really made it look compact, which is nice. I don't like case builds that, you know, there's a lot of empty space in them, but this one makes good use of all of that space and allows you to cram some of the bigger components in them as well. By the way, if you're wondering about where the cables are managed, because this is a pretty slim case, right? Where are they managing to work all those in? Actually, up top. So this isn't what I expected, but you have actually about an inch or so worth of space up there to route most, if not all, of your cables, which is how they were able to keep this build looking so clean in the first place. Now, this is another implementation of the original PC011. They had the ROG version, and this is version 2, if you will, still in the production phase. They're still working out some of the kinks, but they've taken a lot of feedback in from especially the water cooling enthusiast base, those who would be more interested in, let's say, a plus-sized O11 dynamic. So they've taken a lot of the dynamics aspects, thrown it into basically a larger form factor of the O11. So you can see we've got a huge basically vertical bracket in here for two graphics cards. You want to turn those sideways. We have a bracket down below, which should allow for a much easier radiator installation on the bottom. Instead of having to turn your case on its side to screw in things from the bottom, you could just drop that bracket in. Very simple. People were asking for covers. If you're not going to use the fan mounts that are basically beside the motherboard tray, you could cover those up. Those are included in this case as well. You can see we've got the ROG trim up front and in the glass up front as well. There's just so much in this case that has been just taken care of, and they are definitely keeping enthusiasts in mind. We even have fan mounts now at the rear against the rear IO shield for up to 120 mil fan, it looks like. That's something that the PC011 Dynamic didn't have. Again, the enthusiast version, the ROG version, will have that version too. And we actually even have an extra two bays for hard drives. So we had one before with the original Dynamic. Now we have a second one because this case is taller, which means it'll fit a lot more in it. There's more space on the left side as well for larger graphics cards. That was occasionally an issue as well for the PC011 Dynamic. So there's a lot with this one. Again, it's not in production yet. They're still working on some things, but I can tell you, as somebody who used to build a lot of custom loops in PCs like these, I can't wait to get my hands on this one because there's so much space here. You could put just a huge reservoir. You could put radiators and fans down below. Now, underneath your graphics card, still have room for vertical mounts. You can put radiators and fans along the back next to the motherboard, and you can place them up top. Still plenty of room to work with for tube routing, cable routing, all of that. So this one's really got me excited because it's just an enthusiast version of the PC011 Dynamic, basically, with the ROG stamp of approval on it. And I can't wait for this one to hit the market. And we're going to end on, let's spin on the DK computer desk. This is actually, I don't know how you want to call this, like a two-tone glass. You can control with just a remote here. Basically, there's a current being run through the bottom glass panel. And then, you click a button and you can see through it. This is especially useful, first off, if you want to buy something as enthusiast grade as this. It's going to look really good. I really want one of these. On top of that, though, the ability to change the basically tint of the glass or how transparent it is great for those who, let's say, have a monitor right here on the edge of the desk, but don't want lights shining in their eyes from below. That tends to be an issue as well with just RGB cases, RGB builds. So the ability to kind of muffle all this out, if you will, just by clicking a single button is something that Lee and Lee's been playing around with, and I really like it. I think it's actually a good idea. They want to know what you guys think about this, and we're looking price point wise. The original DK computer desk was going for about $999, and then we're thinking for the extra feature here that you're seeing, this is actually not cheap to do at all. Maybe $1,199, somewhere in that price point. So what do you guys think about this? I know this isn't for everybody, but if you've got the money to spend, you want something that really stands out, then this would definitely do it. Other than that, I know you can't really see me, but we've had a great time here walking through the Lee and Lee suite here at Caesar's Palace. Stay tuned for more content. This is Science Studio. Thanks for traveling with us.